get your popcorn and butter, and dice. Let's calorie and take your seat. Silence your phones.
Tejano TV presents.
It's the Three Amigos Show! Starring Big Daddy D. Burleson, the Midnight Cowboy Marcus Daniels, E.L. Guy Juan Mendoza. Tonight's special guest, Adriana Guzman of Adriana and the Boyz. Brought to you by Mas Chingon Radio, LilaLisaPromotions.com, Hacienda International Productions. Musician Danny Farias. Bar Azul Tequila. Taste the new face of tequila. Archie's Homestyle Burgers in Cotulla, Texas. The Tejano Conjunto Music Superstore, Jamie's Record Shop. And Tejano TV. And now, let's get on with the show.
Hello, I had to make a late entrance.
Wait till Juan gets back and realizes the.
I was trying to look for my sponsor sheet, man. I forgot it.
Why is everything lagging? I'm.
Your internet, man.
Everybody's frozen on my screen.
Yeah, your internet.
Continuous.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us here on another great episode of the Three Amigos Show, right here on Tejano TV. So, ladies and gentlemen, we got a big announcement for you guys. As of this morning, we are now available on Google Play. So, if you guys have an Android, you can download it or scan the QR code right there, which we'll be having on the screen throughout the show, and you can download Tejano TV and watch all of our great shows. The Three Amigos Show, Cantamos con Vicky B, the Top 10 Music Video Countdown, Giras y Desveladas, and the Tejano Time Podcast with Keith Leal, and much, much more. So make sure you guys download it on Google Play. And of course, we want to thank our sponsors, my baby Lila Cervantes with Lila Lee's Promotions, Archie's Homestyle Burger, Danny Farias, Hacienda International. I forgot my sheet.
And we got course, Archie's Homestyle Burgers in Cotulla, Texas. We also have Jamie's Record Shop. We have Hacienda International Productions. And of course, we have our sponsor, Mar Azul Tequila, right here.
The new
and
face.
This is going great. This is wonderful. This is one of the weirdest broadcasts to start so far. Great.
Yes. And I'm El Mas Chingon, Juan Mendoza.
And I'm Diddy Boom Boom. How y'all doing, folks?
And good. Thank you. Thank you for having us.
And we are the Amigos and the Boyz.
Oh, okay. That's what we're waiting for. Nice. Well, thank you guys so much for joining us. We really appreciate your time. And thank you to Slick Rick for hooking us up and setting this interview up as well. So,
appreciate it. Yes. Thank you.
Big shout out to Slick Rick. Yes, for sure.
Nice. So how's everything going?
It's going good. It's going really good. With this new single that we have coming out or that has come out, it's been opening up a lot of new doors and obviously some good interviews. And so, yeah, we're pretty excited about the whole thing.
Wait. Hold the show. Hold on. Juan is the worst interviewer ever. He goes, how's it going? No. Ladies and gentlemen, we have Adriana and the Boyz here on Tejano TV on the Three Amigos Show. And for those of you that do not know who Adriana and the Boyz are, they're from Elgin, Illinois, right?
Originated, yes, in Elgin, Illinois. Mm-hmm.
I live in Joliet, Illinois.
Okay, but we all say Chicago.
Chicago.
Yeah, well, suburbs of Chicago.
Chicago, that's close enough. And so tell the audience, who are Adriana and the Boyz? What do you do? Where do you come from? And how did it get started?
Well, Adriana and the Boyz had originated here in Elgin, Illinois, back in 2012.
Yes.
With myself, my manager, who is my husband, who he's a great big part of the whole big thing, as he's been able to find a lot of good band players. And we just decided to figure, you know, to kick it off with Tejano, because I actually originated with conjunto music. But decided to give Tejano music a good try, which it's been working ever since. And since then we've been going, you know, we've been doing pretty good.
We get.
Well, what are Tejano audiences like in the upper states?
It is pretty good here in the Midwest. We do have some fans and great followers, and I guess in the Chicago area, there's not that many places that you can go to, but there is definitely, you know, Wisconsin, Michigan, Ohio. So we have a variety of places where we can, you know, extend our music and share it to all of them as well.
And there's also a community of dancers, you know, people, these dancers that go, they support Tejano music from Michigan to Ohio to around Chicago. Those dancers, I mean, they don't get credit, but these are the people that
keep the music.
As long as you dance, I'll keep playing. You know, and I see that, you know, that's the way I see it. But yes, thanks to the dancers, the community of dancers that go around checking the yes. That hasn't died out. It's getting better, you know, but people are dressing up again to go to the dance. And you see older generations, mid generations, and young generations. You see all three generations attending, so that's a good sign.
Are there any stations out there that actually play Tejano or anything similar?
There's not too many that are like 24/7.
Well, I need to check something real quick, because everybody's frozen on my screen.
It's probably you. I mean, nobody's freezing on my end.
You both look alive to me.
Close the match.
probably need to log off and log back on again.
Okay, so the show's running normally. It's just over here. I'm going to log out and log back in, and hopefully that'll clear things up. Everybody's frozen, and I'm hearing things like really delayed.
We're gonna do a little IT work on the air. On your keyboard, hit control shift. Never mind now. He just logged off. I was going to tell him to hit control shift Windows B. That'll clear your memory card. But anyway, so, but yeah, there's any stations out there that play Tejano music?
Not full-time stations. There's some stations that, you know, they may come on like on the weekend or, you know, during the day sometimes, but not like, you know, it would be like in Texas or something like that, you know. There's a lot of guys that do it part-time, but not 24/7, you know.
Has the scene grown? Because I know you guys go to like Wisconsin to get a lot of Tejano action out there, especially in the big festivals and stuff. Do they have any around that area?
It hasn't disappeared, you know. It's just not as popular as the pop culture, you know, the Peso Plumas and that type of popularity and the Frontera groups, right? And, however, there is a community of Tejano, I call it South Texas culture, you know, the dancers, the musicians that always, you know, supporting each other from town to town. And that hasn't disappeared. I think it's getting better now, you know, now with, like, now we're able to, so I'm meeting you through the internet, right? Where I had to travel to Texas, you know, to go do an interview with you, right?
Yes.
So this makes it a little easier. Yeah. So like, again, thank you. Thank you, D. Thank you, Machingon, for allowing us to take a little bit of us, and through you, we can give it to the world.
All right. Well, we got another special guest here. Slick Rick.
Oh, no.
You don't know.
What's going on, Slick?
Hello. Hey, how y'all doing?
Good, thank you.
Hey. It's dark over there on your end, man. You can turn on a light.
Well, he's hiding out, man.
Witness protection.
How y'all doing, Adriana?
I'm doing good. How are you?
Good. It's been a while since I've seen you.
Yes. Oh, yeah. So this is Slick Rick. I'm sorry. It is too dark. And we can't see you very well.
He said, you always notice you never see Slick Rick and Batman in the same place at the same time.
How's Beto?
He's doing really well. He's actually, he had to step away because he likes to watch it on the fans' end and take a look at it. But yeah, we're doing really good. How are you?
I've been following you, and I'm loving that new CD, single you got.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, and I was telling Dee and Juan and them, I said, we need to get her on here. We get you on there. So yeah, it's good to have you.
Yes, because I know you've been trying to reach out for a very, very long time. Even when I was, you know, recording the collaboration with Santiago with your brother Joe.
Yeah.
You had even tried then, you know, but I don't know what happened, you know.
Well, that's what I was.
I know what happened. You know, she's recording and she looks at her phone. Oh, it's Rick again.
Yeah.
Why is this guy stalking me?
Leave me alone.
But we're glad to have Adriana here because there's one thing I have a pet peeve. It's when a woman has her name plastered out there, Adriana Guzman and the boys. You know, and I've noticed that you haven't even introduced the boys. They're just sitting in the background. Nobody's been.
This is my support system.
No, yeah. Hey, I'm talking here. Hold on a second, because I want to give the musicians their due. You guys work hard. She's the princess. She gets everything handed to her, her own rooms, her own dressing room. And then you guys have to, you know, 2 a.m, you try to find a Whataburger. They don't even have Whataburger up there. You try to find a Waffle House or something to eat.
Waffle House.
No. I'm sorry, I didn't say White Castle.
See, she gets what she wants. And that's the way it is when you have a female lead singer. They just get, you know, they're like this all the time. It's all
and,
me.
And he's speaking from experience.
I am. I worked with Patsy Torres. I worked with Dylan Gonzalez. I love female partners, but they are such a pain in the neck. Right, guys? Come on, back me up.
I don't know nothing.
I ain't trying to get fired, man, so I'm not going to say that.
You're trying to get them all fired, man.
Fired on their day off. Okay.
She's going to find some new boys to work with.
Yeah.
I
enjoy all of their time that they've spent with me and help, you know, boost my how do I say that?
Thank you. He nailed it right on the head. Ego. Oh, man.
I was trying to introduce myself earlier, D, but your computer was freezing, so you didn't hear it.
That was my
fault. I'm kidding. My name is Miguel. And I'm the bass player, and she'll tell you I've been stalking her since before I started playing with her. Although I've been a fan of hers for like past 12, 15 years anyway. So, and I'm very excited and happy to be a part of her band now. Been a fan for a long, long time. So,
and who's awesome. The chatty guy next to you that you know? Man, you can't shut this guy up. Who's next to you?
Hi, I'm Tony Chavez. I'm the guitar player. Nice to meet you guys. Thank you for having us. We enjoy supporting this girl. I've been playing with her for a long time and just enjoying the whole thing. I appreciate you guys for your support.
Well, we're glad you're here because I've got questions. Well, I've made observations. First off, I love her. Adriana, I love your voice. You've got a combination like Elida / Laura Canales. When I say Laura Canales, I mean, you have an honesty in your voice. Like when you sing, it's like, I've lived this. I know what I'm talking about. And it's honest.
Yes.
And so, has she been down in the dumps and, you know, in the gutter and stuff? And so when she sings about it, because your voice has an honest feel to it. It's a great, great voice. And I thoroughly enjoy it. And Oy Me Voy is such a great song. So whose idea was that one? Come on, somebody.
D, first of all, thank you. I know you from before. We'll get into that. That's for another story. Anyway.
Tell all the stories.
Another day.
No. Don't tell them anything. You open the door to spill it, Caesar.
No, thank you. Thank you for allowing us again to promote our, you give us this opportunity to promote our music to the world, right? But for me, the vocal here is the focal point. For me, like I told you, your vocal is what I enjoy, right? No matter what we play, whether it's Tejano or cumbia or ballad, anything, the vocal or conjunto, anything, the vocal is, for it's enjoyable for me to continue to play and have fun, because if it's not fun, I don't want to do it, right?
What are we doing if it's not fun?
Right. So that, to me, the vocal is, it's, you're leading the vocal and I enjoy it. And I think everybody who participated in the recording agrees the vocal is the focal point instead of.
Well, that's what I gravitated to first, was just the way she sings is correct. Just like, wow, okay, she knows what she's talking about, or she's like the camarada with it, where she could tell you something, girl, you need to leave him, and she believes you. I trust you.
That is so nice. I trust your voice.
Yeah, I enjoy that, right? It's like now, when I hear that, I'm like, man, I'm going to dance with that. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Are any of you from Texas?
No, they're posers, man. They're posers.
In my case, I was born here in Chicago in 1968.
Oh.
When I turned 18 in the 80s, I started working in Texas as a Tejano musician with a group called La Sombra de Chicago.
Yeah, I think I've heard of that.
That was in the 80s. That was in the 80s. Everything was starting to take off.
Yeah.
You know, so from the 80s till 2005, 20 years, I spent working as a Tejano musician in Texas for many different schools, and they were all great schools. So I had 20 years invested in not just the music, but learning the culture, South Texas culture, you know, the conjunto, the country, more so in the city.
I got to ask you a question.
Yes, sir.
Did you find it difficult to work with musicians who weren't Tejano musicians and trying to get them to understand where it comes from and the groove and
yes. How to play? And glad you cut your, it's a good question, because that's what we try to share. It's not so much the how many notes you can put in, the accents, the decorations. It's the groove. Because the groove, you're going to make me want to dance through your groove, right? Not your decorations, yeah. You know. But we work on it. We work on that.
Yeah. Well, the reason why I was asking if you guys are
musicians. That was my problem, because New Mexico, all the rancheras are like, slow down.
Well, no, the reason why I was asking, because you guys got that, like, the Corpus Christi style of Tejano music.
South Texas.
Laura Canales.
Yes. You're right. You know what? That was the vision on this, you know, because that was my school. Mayo, you know, when the Fender Rhodes, remember the Fender Rhodes? The synthesizers, the Moogs.
The suitcase? Wow.
Yeah.
So,
you know, it's organic ingredients, you know. So that was the vision, to try to keep it an organic recording, right? The brass is real brass. It's not a synthesizer. It's not an artificial ingredient. It's a real ingredient. It's natural. It's, you know, because nowadays you can open up a box like a meal, right? You open up a box from the freezer, open it, put it in the microwave, boom, you have a meal. You know, you have a, you know. No, this was made
from scratch.
This was made with, I think, with a lot of love, first of all.
Yeah.
First of all, a lot of love, you know. And again, the vocal is the focal point. But with that idea of, like you said, the Bobby Naranjo, the old Mayo school, that was part of that's part of the school. Yes, it is.
Yeah.
So, Adriana, how much homework did you have to do? Or did you grow up listening? You said you started with conjunto, but who were you listening to?
Well, It all comes from my roots from when I was younger. I come from a background of a family who has done nothing but, you know, I have all my uncles basically are performers. They're musicians. So I grew up with the conjunto style type of music from them. And because my parents are from Texas, we got to hear both worlds with it being conjunto and Tejano. And so just with growing up, I feel like it just is stuck in the bones for me.
Now, how come you seem like a pop singer to me? That's what your favorite thing is, pop music. But if you'll notice, a lot of the best entertainers are all crossovers, because Bobby Pulido is a great country and western singer, yeah. But he's an international star now because he's switched over. And well, me too. I was, you know, R&B funk, and then here I am. It's like, oh, okay. So, I've got that. You've got that pop kind of feel to you. Is that what you enjoy? Well, tell us about your music history.
It's all conjunto and Tejano music. I I'm from the 80s. Yes, we did listen to a lot of the 80s and 90s music, but it really didn't stick to me as much as I do for my love for Tejano and conjunto music.
But that makes you an outcast. That made you an outcast in high school, didn't it? Where you listened to what? Girl, please.
you know, when I was, you know, getting ready for high school, yeah, I would listen to MTV and, you know, whatever music was playing with around my friends, of course. But in my room, you know, in the shower, I was listening to Laura Canales, to Selena, to Shelly, to, you know, La Mafia. I mean, the list goes on. That is what was always playing in my home, you know, growing up. So
when are you guys coming to Texas?
I hope, hopefully pretty soon. Hopefully soon. Yes. I like Texas.
because here in Texas, well, I'm in Colorado, actually. I keep going here.
I was going to ask you. We go to Colorado.
I live in Colorado now, but in Texas, we're a big family. I mean, so you'll get to run into Shelly and all the Shelly, Stephanie Montiel, and all the Angelica Alcocer, and they'll welcome you because you are singers and singers, yeah. Who have a rich love of this music, and it's. I'm glad that we got to find you. Thank you, Rick. First off, for having this.
Yeah, thank you.
I'll tell you one thing, there is a difference between Chicago and Texas. You know, Chicago is really fast, super fast. I don't like it personally. I like to go visit, but I wouldn't want to live there. Compared to Texas, Texas is a lot slower paced, especially South Texas. You know, I love it. I love the culture, you know, the whole culture from you know, the rancho, the bajo sexto, the accordion, and that's how you grew up, you know, in the.
Yeah.
It's in the household every day, you know, so every weekend. So that nice. Helps.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Let's go ahead and get some shout outs because we have people who are commenting here and wanting to say hello. Again? Okay. No, I was. That's my fault. I was talking too much.
No, I know the drill.
We have Junior Thomas. He says, yes. Slick Rick says, how y'all doing? How come I didn't get an invite to come on? That's kind of spooky. Keith Leal says saludos, Juan and D, and you guys can catch his show every week here on Tejano TV as well. Let's see, we got DJ Brandon from Pearsall, Texas. Saludos,
Pearsall.
Puro Pearsall. Saludos desde Tejano Swag Radio, Gonzalez, Texas.
Sean Sobrano.
What's going on, brother?
Sean, I know you, Sean. Sean Zambrano. If you're watching, saludos.
We got Theo Earl in the house. Hola, friends. ¿Cómo están, everyone?
Wait. You know what? We need to get Earl on the show tonight since Marcus isn't here. We have a two black guy limit. So
you gotta fill in the quota.
You're invited, man.
You gotta fill in the quota.
Yeah, we got a quota. So
we gotta make sure
you're invited to the show tonight.
We got to make sure we don't get him in trouble with the station over there first.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, you might get fired over there, and then we'll have to recruit him over here. Stirring the pots. Don't stir the pot.
Ooh, I think I'm gonna hide. I need to.
he said, "Thank you." Bye. He said, "Thank you, Juan, for tuning into the show last night. Thank you for your support and friendship. Keep up the great work. Much love from your favorite Theo Uncle Earl from you know where, from K Alamo, San Antonio." Told you, Richard Lopez. Shout out to Adriana the Boyz, Midwest Illinois.
Gracias, Richard. Thank you.
Compa, say saludos. Saludos. What's going on, saludos. Compa? So you got Richard, Adriana and the Boyz are awesome group, my hometown of Midwest Illinois.
Gracias.
Alex, what's going on, Alex?
Grupo Básico.
What's up, guys? What's going on, brother? Appreciate you tuning in. Bobby Castaneda from California. Adriana, music sounds awesome.
Thank you.
Bass player. Thank you.
Nice. Richard Lopez, good. Looking forward to May 18, 2024 in Aurora, Illinois. Adriana and the Boyz live.
Mm-hmm. Actually, Joliet, Illinois, on May 18th.
There you go. Juanita Chapa, hola amigos. Adriana and the band, happy to see Juanita. All of you. Thank you, Juanita, for tuning in.
Thank you.
Dulces Martinez says, love me some Adri.
Yes.
Thank you, Dulces.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dulces and Copa, for tuning in. Puro Pedo Talk Show. Saludos, amigos. Thank you for tuning in, you guys. Also from that other station. Richard Lopez. Shout out to your amigos. Juan Mendoza, D. Marquez. I do it out of love. Don't worry about it. Castaneda, this band sounds like they will have a passion for Tejano music like me.
Yes, thank you. That's true.
Yes, they do.
Texas is cool. Ricky Duran from Houston, Texas, already. Houston's Tejano hits out there in Houston, Texas. Saludos a todos.
Hello.
Love from DJs out there, guys.
Yeah, a lot of DJs tuning in.
It's a good sign.
See you soon on the 25th. I don't know what's going on the 25th. Oh. Monica Cortez, MC2 from Houston, says, Hola. You know, Monica was one of my first interviews when I got into the internet radio.
Really? And you know what's funny is he was the first person that ever introduced me to collaborate a song with him. Really? So yes, I do have a collaboration on one of his CDs. I think it's MC2. But yeah. Yes, and we actually did No Lastimes Más from
Lavender. Oh my God, I'm gonna have to look for that again. I remember getting that CD from him when we interviewed him. My buddy Adriana.
Yes.
David Vela says hello. David Vela, Oakland in the house. Oakland is watching. Oakland, California. Ricky Zoran says phone interview on the 25th, Houston's TejanoHits.com.
That's right. Looking forward to that one as well.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much for tuning in. If you guys have any more questions, just send them right in.
Don't forget.
Don't forget. All right, D, back to you.
I've got a question right off the bat. Adriana, would you? Because he's been saying Adriana and Adriana. Which one is it? Because Juan can't make up his mind.
It's Adriana.
Now, see, you guys are frozen again to me. I don't know if you answered.
I am Mexican-American. We say it two different ways.
Yes.
That's true. I call her boss lady. Boss lady.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, let's go ahead and get into a video here. Okay, we usually have our cue.
I'll log out and log back in.
We usually have our cue guy here. That usually says, "Hey, what about a video?" But he's not here right now. So, but we got a video here. There you go. I think this was back in 2018 at the fanfare, and I think you guys were playing with Chago on one of the stages there.
Yeah.
So this is Adriana and the Boyz and Chago at fanfare. singing Cuatro Caminos right here on the Three Amigos Show, Tejano TV.
Thank you. Tejano TV and Mastering on Radio. We want to let you know that we now have merchandise on sale. So make sure you guys go to MachoGunRadio.com and click on the TTV shop. And, of course, you can get shirts, you can get koozies, you can get tumblers. And right now, for a limited time, you can get a shirt, a tumbler, and a koozie for $50. Make sure you guys purchase yours. And it makes a great gift for the hardcore Tejano fans and, of course, the hardcore Tejano TV fans. So make sure you guys get you a shirt, a koozie, and a tumbler right now for $50.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back. And, of course, I was Adriana and the Boyz. And, of course, Chago out there at Fanfare. I think it was 2018. That was an awesome show. That was an awesome song you guys did.
Thank you. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. I mean, we flown in that weekend, recorded, and ended up at the TTMA Fanfare all in that one weekend. And yeah, it was a lot of fun. It was.
That was the last time I seen you.
Yeah.
That was the last time, because I remember y'all went to go record at the...
Yes, at the Cat Studios, I think it was. Yeah. Cat Studios. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you guys have festivals like that over there where you're at?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, we actually have one coming up for the...
Morris?
No, there's a smaller one in Delavan, Wisconsin, Cinco de Mayo Fest.
Oh, yeah.
That's we'll be playing there. The big one festival they have out here in the Midwest is the Mexican Fiesta. That's out in Milwaukee. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but that'll be at the end of August. We won't be there this year, but hopefully maybe next year we can make it that, you know, to that. So we'll see what happens.
Was that the last time you guys came to Texas? That Fanfare?
Or you came. You went.
Me, myself, yeah. That was the last time.
Yeah, we weren't part of her band then yet.
Oh, you guys are rookies.
I was with her.
Yeah. I was in Texas a couple of weeks ago in the valley, in La Villa. We were adding the Fender Rhodes on the piano and the song. You remember the Fender Rhodes?
Yeah.
Yeah. So we added the Fender Rhodes in the valley. Ahí con mi compadre Noel Hernandez. I don't know if you know Noel Hernandez, bass player.
He
took part in this. He participated. He has a lot to do with this arrangement as well. You know, so I was down there with Noe, and that's doing the horn arrangements with Rene Gasca. Also participated in this album doing the horns.
And, thank you.
Yeah, man. Thank you, guys.
A big shout out to all the guys that helped out with this song.
Yeah, Turi Alviar from the Valley. That's why you get that South Texas compas, because it is South Texas musician. It's Turi Alviar on the drums. You know, he's from El Cauche. He's playing with those Delta Boyz right now. He played with Los Frijoles Románticos. So I was part of that school with Los Frijoles myself, Epi, and that was my last school, and that was my best school. And ahí toda la clica y la palomía de ahí del Valle, del Cauche, La Vía. So that's why there's a lot to do with that field, you know, because you have South Texas musicians doing the foundation, and it's a very South Texas compás, you know, groove.
Well, look who you guys were playing with there too. You know, yeah, Chago, Santiago Garza, who's also from Corpus Christi area, you know, South Texas.
Simón, South Texas. Yes.
Conjunto. He's predominantly Conjunto. So he's a good guy. We met him at the internet. Well, I met him before, but we saw him at the Internet Radio Gala and Fanfare this past month. Go ahead.
Oh, no. I want to get down to the controversy and stuff, because, see, I keep asking Rick for information, and Rick is like, I don't want to talk about it. I'm going, okay, because I saw like two Facebook pages of Adriana and the Boyz, and there's two different bands. And so I was like, wait, who are these guys in this Facebook page, and who are the guys on this Facebook page? I was like, so who got fired and why? I want to know what's going on.
you put her in the spot.
There was another page. There was, yeah.
There's two pages out there, because I do the artwork and stuff, so I was looking for pictures, and so I went, hey, are these the same person? And then, hey, who are these guys? So
she's changing her profile pictures right now.
Yeah.
I wanted to cover page from when you get my last class.
Actually, I'm sorry. I'm Tony here. If I could interject in this, nobody got fired. We work with a group of close tight musicians that everybody's putting their own little flavor into it. And it's just a collaboration of different musicians that want to see this young girl succeed. And that's what it's all about, actually. So you're going to see pictures of a guy helping us out on keyboard or somebody else. But in all essence, it's all about the voice, like my friend Cesar was saying. It's all about her. So, but you very noticed it. You noticed that right away.
Oh, man. No. I'm the investigator around here. I get to the bottom of things. And so I just wanted to know, like, what was that? Because, like, right now she's claiming innocence. She's like, what, Facebook page? What are you talking? Where? Those pictures of you, dear.
I'm sure they are, but again, I've been doing this for a very long time, and have met people, and you know, just trying to give everybody, you know the chance to help me out. You know, there's not that very many musicians here, at least in the Chicago area, at least from what I know. And so that we've been able to get these guys, it's been exceeding and just going like 100 miles an hour right now as we're collaborating and coming up with new songs and, you know, and just trying to come up even with new covers for our performances. So it's been a lot of fun. But yeah, I've had, you know, I've been in this for a long time.
Well, why didn't you just say your boyfriend was in the other band? You kicked him to the curb. He left with the guys, and so you got a new band. That's all you had to say.
They claimed custody. They shared custody, or one claimed custody, and the other one lost.
Yeah, you guys, I'm gonna have to look that one up.
I'm just yanking your chain, guys. I just saw that.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Do you have or is it? Are you able to put that last video I sent you of her?
Which video?
She's got black on. I think she's singing Elida.
Oh, she's singing.
Oh, the Elida one? No, I didn't get a chance to get that one. I got another one that she's doing, Laura Canales.
Okay. That's a good one. The one, yeah. I like heard when I hear it, you know, I've been going through all your shows and stuff. It's Stephanie's La Comadre.
Oh yeah, okay. Yeah. I like that. Everyone likes to dance to that for some reason. Is that te pone a bailar?
Yeah. That's a good, you know, she I seen the video and then I said, man, she's getting everybody out there dancing, you know. So look, yeah, she does a good job on that.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So what can we do to help get you guys to Texas, to get you in front of Tejano audiences so that you can get the recognition that you deserve? Because you're a great band, great vocalist, and you guys have a lot of great energy, and that needs to be seen here. So I'm glad we've got a lot of DJs on the line here this evening that have been making comments and stuff. We need to demand that the promoters in all of the different towns get, you know, book you, so that they can experience the wonder of Adriana and the Boyz.
The yes. HR is commenting Uh-oh. Towards you.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
HR said, don't cause no trouble.
I had a question. That was all. I just wondered why there were two bands and, you know.
Yeah. No. Go ahead.
Was it like a West Side Story? Was it the Sharks and the Jets? You know, they had the bands fought. You guys won or what? I don't
know. No, nothing like that. No,
the
I
boys
promise.
Are having their way tonight. The boys are having their way tonight. What did they start to run? We're ready to mix. Oh, sorry.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, no, but you could definitely contact our manager, who is my husband. Okay. And You can contact Beto Rios at, I can provide the number. It's 224-523-9141 for all of the bookings, so that we would be able to go out there and show what we have. We would love to. We would love to, you know, visit San Antonio and show what Adriana and the boys have for you.
What about that? You expected me to write that fast? The number was.
Hey, you have speech to text nowadays.
Right.
Not on my end.
Yes, the number is 224.
Wait, 224, 234.
224.
Okay, 224.
523-9141.
See, because I control technology and stuff like that, so I can do this. You know.
There you go.
Awesome. That's awesome.
We didn't have that back in the 90s.
I know. Everybody grab a pen and write down this number. That's
what
it was. I know.
That's what we were thinking about doing. Yeah.
Hey, Adriana.
Let me take the moment to give some shout-outs, because I know we're talking about giving us down to Texas, but I'd like to give a shout-out to some of the promoters that have helped us from day one up this way, you know, in the Midwest, starting with Esteban and Rachel Perales out of Midwest Conjunto Promotions.
Yes, thank you.
Big fans of ours, big fans of hers, and they have helped her promote, hired us, you know, given us work throughout the years. R&R Tejano Productions as well.
Mm-hmm.
Robert, Rosa, they're out there too, doing dances, hiring us, sharing our videos, sharing the events, you know, so we can't forget those that have been helping us along the way. But yeah, hopefully this opens the doors to a lot more things. And even with DJ radios, I've known DJ Phil Melon from Tejano Network for about 20 years. I always tease him. I said, I'm glad I can say I knew you before you were DJ Phil Melon. He's a big supporter. You know, he's been a big supporter of me and other groups I've been with, but he really loves how she sings too. So big shout out to those guys.
Big friend, a good friend of ours from Sunnyside, California. So awesome.
Yeah. Actually, speaking of work, so we're going to have an event May 18th. It's going to be, we're billing a double feature. It's Adriana The Boyz and Ivani Grupo Fuego.
Yeah.
I'm sure you've heard of her. They're going to be co-headlining an event. DJ Firmelon is flying in to MC this event for us. Nice. So that's going to be a pretty big dance, and hopefully anybody that's watching in the area can make it out to Joliet, Illinois, Royal Palace, May 18th. Adriana and the Boyz, Ivani Grupo Fuego, double feature. It's going to be a hell of a night.
It's going to be a blast.
You know what, guys? First off, I've seen hundreds and hundreds of bands. And yes, Adriana, before we started this show tonight, she says, do you mind if I have the couple of the guys on? You brought your team. You brought your, because everybody has a different job. Somebody knows promoters and all the somebody knows all the DJs. Somebody knows the history and how the music's organized and how the recordings are made. You've got your team behind you, and a lot of bands do not. So congratulations to you guys.
Thank you very much.
You know, and to answer your question, you know, Juan, the and Rick, what can you do to help us out? You're already doing it.
Thank you.
You know, you're doing it right.
We've got to be able to do more.
Thank you. You know, because, man, it's a bridge, right? You're putting it out to the world, and I think it works both ways. And I'm glad that you enjoying the listening to the review you've given the single. You know, you noticed, you know, the quality, and that's, you know. Like, again, man, I want to ask you guys some questions too.
And you know, and if I could say, I mean, your opinions mean a lot. D, especially, like, I've been a fan of yours since forever, man. I watching you guys perform on the Tejano Award shows.
Forever, man,
dude. I used to dance along to your step, man. Watching those videos, man. When I was younger and a lot thinner. So, but anyway, when you talk about history and all that, I mean, I'm the encyclopedia over here, man. I can tell these guys a lot about, you know, different artists and whatever, because I mean, I love the culture, the music, man, since I was probably about 8. And speaking of it, you guys asked if we were from Texas. Man, my family's from Mexico. I'm the only one born here in the United States. how the heck I wound up being such a fan of the Tejano music. And I remember in grade school, I would always say, I'm going to be in a Tejano band when I grow up.
And you support it.
And my classmates used to tease me. And some of those same classmates have hired me in other bands for the weddings in quinceañeras and whatnot. So, you know, I laugh at it now, but I've been a fan for that long. So, again, you know.
Well, the mission here at Tejano TV, first off, is that, you know, we all know who the favorite artists are. You know, you see them all the time. You see their videos. But the radio stations and the DJs have had a hard time promoting the up-and-coming artists, the people who are not so well-known, who are really, really good and just haven't had the opportunity or the don't get the screen time or the radio time. And what we're trying to do is to change a lot of that, and that is to recognize good groups that play great music, sound good, entertain well, and let people know that they're out there. People, and if they say Tejano is dead one more time, I'm going to strangle somebody.
It's just a lot of the circle. It revolves around the same handful of artists, but they don't know that there's a lot more Tejano out there.
Let's start naming names. Come on, name names, Juan. I'll start with Intocable, and then we go to
David Lee, Emilio, Jay,
Selena,
Mas. You know, it's all the same handful. No offense to any of those guys, but
all great performers and artists.
Yeah, but there's more to it than just the same five names. And that's the purpose of what we got here, is that we're trying to bring different artists from no matter where they from the Midwest, from Mexico, from California, from Florida, from Arizona, New Mexico, everywhere. New artists that are trying to get into the Tejano genre, we're trying to bring those in. And that's the reason why Tejano TV was invented, Mas Chingon Radio, because on Mas Chingon Radio, we don't play any old school music. We love it. We just don't play because there's too many stations doing it. And it just takes away from, I think it just takes away from the up and coming artists.
Or it narrows the focus too much. There's so much more out there, and you can't just look at those few. And gosh.
Well, right now, we're working at a local level, you know, around the Midwest locally. And you know what? There's a community of dancers, and there's the proof. You know, when we play, my reward is seeing you dance.
Mm-hmm.
That's my reward. When I see you dance, man, you're feeding me that you wanted to play.
We all know that if you're having fun, they're having fun, and vice versa. So
yeah, so that's happening. That's happening. It's alive. It's not gone anywhere. You know, it's there.
Yeah.
Okay, but I gotta warn you though. Take that out of your vocabulary. Working on a local level, because within this in this age of social media, you're working on a global level. You can reach.
You're right. You're right.
You've got to do your end and promote.
Put out. Yeah, I think that's.
Make sure people know that you're. If they don't know, they're not going to show. So you make sure that people.
Right. You're right.
Where you're playing, when you're playing.
You're right. And we have a vision, you know, to expand always, to always improve. Right. We do have that vision, so you know.
Okay.
Everything at its due time, right?
See, I got to confess, though, see, because I've been making fun of social media, TikTokers and YouTubers and Instagram people, and like, oh, yeah, these kids, it's a kid thing. No, it's not, because these influencers is what they're called now. These people on TikTok, people on Instagram, people on YouTube, they're being watched, and if they're promoting your music, that's only going to help you. And so I've had to get on the social media wagon. I'm still terrible at it. I got on TikTok for the first time today.
Yeah. Congratulations.
No. I found out that there was like 200 messages for Culturas on there. Somebody's got to read these. Okay.
Yeah.
I'll be up late. That's in the video.
But yeah, I mean, social media, I mean, look, you got somebody watching from Oakland. You got people watching in from Mexico. Yeah.
Look at the comments.
You know, everywhere in Texas, you know, Washington State. You got people, Florida, people watching everywhere right now.
Look at Rick right now.
Yeah, and he's stalking the new artists and stuff like that, ready to get them on too. But you got people from all over the place, and they're right now they're going to listen to your music and say, wow, this is an awesome group right here. let's see if we can try to bring those guys over here, you know. And hopefully, yeah. Like, you got Eddie Olivo, man. He's from California. And he's going to fly out there to be with you guys. That's from California.
Yeah. So, that's awesome. So grateful.
Yeah. Thank you, Juan, man. Thank you, Rickos, man. You're right. The vision is to maybe travel and take our music to the world. And through you, like I said, we're doing it right. But that's, like I said, local level right now. But, you know, we do have a vision to always develop and travel, especially, you know, take it wherever you want it. We'll, you know, we can cut a deal.
There you go. We got Anita Rodriguez. I'm looking forward to the performance in Joliet, Illinois in May. Driving from Holland, Michigan.
Yes. Thank you.
Coming in from Michigan just to watch you guys.
Yes.
Johnny Meadows, he's from New Mexico. Adriana and the Boyz, Contigo Quiero Estar. Best version of the song.
Thank you. That is one of my favorite songs.
I want to hear
Adriana and the Boyz and Ivani Grupo Fuego, Dano Saturday.
Yeah.
Puro Party Time, May 18th, Joliet, Illinois.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
You going? If so, we'll see you then. Norma Salazar and George Salazar are coming with me for this dance. Awesome artist, George Salazar.
Nice. Awesome. Nice. Thank you.
Tejano forever. Tejano. Tejano not going away.
No.
Very true. It's just like today. You know, I was a guest at one of them internet radios. I don't know if you know or. Can I say it? Who it was?
Yeah, go ahead.
I was on Tejano to the Bone today.
We're not scared.
Yes. Well, I mean, I don't know. I'm used to the FM rules, so I mean that's why I have it. Anyway, I was telling them about you, Adriana, and they didn't know. And I showed them some of your clippings and stuff. So he got the information and stuff, so they could start playing your music, you know. And so like I said, you know, I mean, well, you know, my brother, you know, my family, everybody, you know, whatever I can do.
That's awesome. Know, thank you. Out,
you know, and
likewise,
just ask. But you,
thank you.
When you first came over, you did my mom's.
Yes, we did your mom's birthday party. Right? Yes, we did.
Yes. So was the first time I heard you.
Here at Tejano TV, we've got our own team. Rick doesn't like being in the spotlight, which is why his screen is so dark. He's the guy that knows everybody in the industry. I swear. He says, oh, yeah, I can get hold of Stevie D. Psh, here, Stevie, can you do my team? Hey, yeah, I know Adriana. Hold on. Let me contact them.
And they didn't believe I knew you. I said, yeah, I know her. I know her personally.
We didn't say it like that.
Well, you know. I mean, I'm glad that we communicated and you're on the show, and like I said, whatever we can do to push you and
thank you.
I love, and from the first time I heard your voice, I said, whoa. I said, I follow you, you know, on your Facebook and stuff like that. I listen to all your performance that you do at the parties, events and stuff like that, you know, and I'll be reposting them. And I say, you know, I mean, I know where talent is, and I don't want you to put it to waste. You know, I want you to succeed, you know, and like I said, whatever.
Yeah, I appreciate that a lot. Yeah, I do appreciate that a lot. I mean, it takes, again, it's taking my guys to sit here to keep me going. And
we got to push her sometimes.
Yeah, but, you know.
At the same token, the same thing for me, Rick. What makes it enjoyable is your vocal. That's what I enjoy. And I think everybody enjoys it, you know. And that's, I guess, for me, that's the focal point. That's what when I hear that vocal, I was like, man, I want to jam with that vocal. You know, I want to play along with the band, right? Because the jam.
And it's it's a lot of fun.
Well, thanks to you, Miguel. You introduced me to this circle, and I've been involved with the circle for about a year and a half ago. Yeah. So it's been developing, and it's still developing. So I'm enjoying it, man. I think
speaking of development, then Well, no, no, Juan, I just got one more question. So the audience is going to want to know what's next. Is there a new recording in the works? You guys, what's in the future? What's in the immediate future that fans can look forward to? They can hear more about the Adriana The Boyz.
It's all what you want to do, you know.
Well, yeah.
For me, right? I mean, because your vocal is leading, right?
So she's the boss.
And we've covered a lot of different styles, you know, from country to guaguancó, cumbia, ballads, you know, country ballads.
Don't avoid the question.
Whatever you do is going to be good, whether it's with us or with not us or with the boys or not the boys. Whatever you're going to do is going to be good because it's such a good vocal. And it's pleasant.
I mean, what's on the heels of what's next?
So right now we have we bring ideas to her, and obviously the boss lady is gonna sign off and say yes, this is what's gonna be next. So we're kind of like in a pre-production stage right now. A couple of different ideas that we're kicking around. There's an original song that I did that could be a possibility to be next. There's always covers that we have fun with. So there's about two or three songs that we got to see which one we want to attack next. Which, speaking to this song, I've been wanting to give a shout out to Jesse Villarreal. He's written a lot of songs for, you know, Jimmy G, David Garza, Crazy Pimps. He wrote this song. And originally it was a slow song. And when I heard it, I said, you know what, Jesse, let me hear this Tejano style, you know. And I liked it that way better. So then I brought it to her, and then here we are, you know. So I wanted to give a shout out to him, a great songwriter. I have another one song I got from him that's also like on the back burner that we'll be getting out here, hopefully, you know, before the year's up, you know. So that's kind of what's on the works, you know, a single at a time, because nowadays the putting out a whole CD at once, you know, it doesn't work that way, really. The budget. Takes that. Fortuna took 20 years to come out with another CD, right? Oof. So, I mean,
they just released it last week.
I downloaded it when it came out last week. Love it. I love hearing you guys back. But just to say, you know, it's not like the days when the Mas and La Mafia and La Sombra were spitting out two albums a year. It doesn't work that way anymore, you know what I mean? And I mean, we're new to this, you know, we haven't been around like that long, but it's not the same.
The reason I'm pushing you is because we want the exclusive. See, one hand washes the other around here.
Right.
We're going to promote you, but we want the music first, so.
Yeah, she just has to decide which one she wants to go with. And whatever she wants to do next, that's what we're going to do next.
So. Oh, Messina, no.
Well, I'm excited because it could be a slow song.
Women change their mind like the wind, man.
Exactly.
Like
if it was up to me, I would say what's next, but it's not. So
I'm gonna get a lot of hate mail from the women that are watching this show.
Go with the flow.
He's racist and sexist.
Yeah, you can't run for president. Oh, did I say that?
Make a good candidate for presidency.
Yeah.
I'm running for president.
Well, D's got an announcement.
Uh-oh. You do?
He froze.
I'm so sorry. Marcus is, see, it's because Marcus is in.
Yeah, Marcus threw off the whole show.
I am dropping the ball. Ladies and gentlemen, here's what normally happens at this time. And it's gone. No, there it is. Okay, so because... Play! If you follow the Three Amigos show, we all know that it is a one-hour show, but we have never, ever, ever accomplished that. Our shows have been 3 hours, 2.5 hours, and right now, we're just going to give Adriana and the boys the opportunity. Do they want to stay and continue more interview, or do they politely want to bow out and go about their busy lives? So, Adriana and the boys, we're going to give you 10 seconds to decide, do you want to stay for more interview, or do you want to go? You have 10 seconds. So we ask you, Adriana and the boys, do you want to stay or do you want to go?
Stay.
You've got things to do. We understand. We just, we've given artists a way out. They think it's a one-hour show. Then we end up 3 hours. They go, I'll never do that again. So
I don't have to be at work till 6 in the morning, so I'm good. I can stay.
We weren't asking you, actually. You're one of the boys. We're actually asking Adriana. Adriana, you're
Let me disappear now.
Everybody's she's sitting up front. I'm sure she rides up front in the van, doesn't she? On the way to gigs, right? Of course she does. So Adriana, do you want to stay or do you want to go?
Oh, we can stay.
Thank you. That's so nice to hear that you want to stay.
Little known fact that that is Marcus dancing in the video since he's not here to defend himself. you guys so much for being here. We're having a lot of fun. Like I said, the music is great, and we can't wait to see what else you got in store for us. But before we get into that, let's go ahead and get into another awesome video here from you guys. And I think this was... if I remember reading it correctly, I think it was 2013 or something like that.
Put your glasses on, Juan.
No, I'm trying to remember this stuff. I think it was 2013. And she was doing a Laura Canales song, and this one is called Si Vivi Contigo.
Oh, that one.
Right here on the Three Amigos Show.
The Three Amigos Show!
Yeah.
All right. So that's why I asked this.
All right. I always wonder why you play the commercials at the end of the night. I was, my finger was on the button. I was going, I should play the commercial now.
Which commercial?
Oh, this one.
All right, everyone. Juan Mendoza here with Tejano TV and Mastering on Radio. We want to let you know that we now have merchandise on sale. So make sure you guys go to MachoGunRadio.com and click on the TTV shop. And, of course, you can get shirts, you can get koozies, you can get tumblers. And right now, for a limited time, you can get a shirt, a tumbler, and a koozie for $50. Make sure you guys purchase yours. And it makes a great gift for the hardcore Tejano fans and, of course, the hardcore Tejano TV fans. So make sure you guys get you a shirt, a koozie, and a tumbler right now for $50.
This week on the Three Amigos Show.
With a uniquely powerful voice, Geneva comes to the Three Amigos Show. Nominated as Best New Female Artist, she's made her mark on the Tejano industry. Join us on April 10th when Geneva sits down with the boys to discuss her perspective on women in the industry and how she wants to make a change. Be here when we talk to Geneva.
Right here on the Three Amigos Show.
And we're back with more from Adriana and the Boyz. See, that's how you come out of a commercial, Juan. You just...
So actually, yeah, I did play it earlier when you were having technical issues.
Oh.
So I know what I was doing.
Oh.
But it's good to see the commercial again. You can see me again on the commercial. But Rick, what's going on, Rick?
Did you get that video I just sent you?
You're like Marcus.
I love this organization.
No.
I want to go ahead and send a shout out if it's possible.
Yeah.
I want to go ahead and send a shout out to Rosie Allison Promotions Rep. I can't thank her enough for pushing out our single out there to all the radio stations. She has been doing such a phenomenal job just pushing it. So shout out to her. And again, thank you for all of that support that we've been able to receive from her work, you know.
Nice.
And you gotta know that also our baby Lila Cervantes is also has also been out there promoting Hoy Me Voy because it's a great song and everybody has it now, I hope. Because she did a really great job sending it out.
And just to let everybody know, it is streaming on Mashugon Radio. And of course, you guys can vote for it on DJ Nunes Top 20 Countdown every single day. So go to MashugonRadio.com, click on the Top 20 Countdown tab, look for Adriana and the Boyz, and make sure you guys vote for it every single day and get it on the countdown. And of course, a new show every week.
Yeah.
So please, thank you.
since we're in the business here of videos, any videos in the future?
We hope so. The opportunity, I mean, we haven't really gotten that far with the music videos, but yeah, I mean, if it's something that we're able to pull up for the next single,
that's a good idea.
You know, I would be definitely on board for that.
There you go.
What a lot of the audience doesn't realize about videos is before record companies used to do the videos, but now the record companies have all pulled back and all the bands are having to put out their music themselves. Yeah. And so it becomes expensive to do. And so before you could count on the record company saying, well, we'll push this single and you'll have a video with that. And now we're having to do it out of our own pockets and it's tough. So that's why videos are not that prevalent anymore, but we are getting some. We're finding ways around technology and stuff to be able to do it at home. So
that's very true. I actually saw one of the. I can't think of her name now, but there was a video that I saw.
I can tell you that Stephanie Montiel, the video that they did for when they were doing the covers of Hasta Cuando and all the different songs, that was recorded on Zavala's phone. He did the video himself because the director didn't show up and the lighting guy. And so they said, they had everybody there said, we're still going to do this video. So we shot it with his phone and it came out very, very well. So,
Phone,
folks.
Yes, those were some good videos that she actually made. So, yeah, well.
No, we did talk about it.
So behind the scenes, Caesar and I kind of been working on stuff. We hadn't got a chance to talk to you about it, but the gig May 18th, we're going to try to get some live footage for a video for Oi Me Voy.
Yeah.
But we're discussing it with somebody that we know from our town, from Joliet, that's going to be doing the footage, doing the shooting. So we just hadn't told her yet.
They always wait for
surprise.
Yeah.
I'll tell the guys right now, do not surprise her. It is not pretty when you surprise them. You go, what? I'm not dressed for this. My makeup looks a mess. You should have told me weeks ago. Yeah, you don't want that argument. So trust me, I know. Right.
Stevie D, we got Stevie D in the house watching. He's going to be on our show, I think, May 1st.
May 18th.
May 18th. May 18th. Oh, my God. Come on, make up your mind.
First.
I had it.
First.
It's on the calendar. May 1st.
First. Trying to mess me up, man. May 1st, Stevie D. And also, Little Birdie told me that some new music is in the works. So we got to get ready for that here pretty soon. Even Stevie's on top of it. He said May 1st.
Yeah.
How does Stevie D, he looks so smooth in all his videos, man. It's always, he's got the classic chiseled chin and the good looks. It's like he turns his head slowly and it's like, I hate guys like that.
Like one of the male models from Old Spice.
Yeah. hopefully Stevie D looks like the guy that's half man, half horse. Yeah.
Oh, that was Marcus, the guy from Old Spice. He's over there riding the horse and stuff.
Yeah. Stevie D, we love you, man. I was just kidding. I was just joking, man.
Nice. So, new music. I know you guys are going to start trying to figure out what you're going to do for new singles and everything else. What are your events that you guys have coming up besides the one that you mentioned, the big one? Do you have any other ones? Well, no, they got one that's April 15th.
Let's go.
Yeah, go ahead.
Well, a lot of these events that are coming up, for example, you're organizing the
May 18th, with Ivani Fuego, like we said. What we have next is May 5th, Cinco de Mayo Festival in Delavan, Wisconsin. We're doing that. And then May 18th with Ivani Fuego and Joliet. We have something in, I think, July 7th. It's at the Morris Grundy County Fairgrounds. They have their annual fest. We're going to be headlining that out there. There's some other stuff in the works later on in the fall and the summer, but things aren't finalized yet. So until we get those contracts signed and that, then we'll be spreading the word for that. And Raw is available for private parties.
Don't let Juan set you up like that, because I know that you also have lots of private events, weddings and quinceañeras and things like that, that you don't want the public to show up at somebody's private party. Juan's going, so what's coming up next? Well, this Friday, we're going to be in a quinceañera, and you got 20,000 people to show up. And then we ran out of food, we ran out of booze. Yeah, thanks. Thanks,
Juan. Well,
party crashers, man. That's how we do it.
We're also a great wedding band.
That's what I wanted to ask, because as a vocalist, I know it's tough if you're singing by yourself all night long, song after song after song after song, and this starts to say, give me a break. So who picks up the slack? Which guys are you, which of you guys are doing the other songs?
Well, for the majority of crickets.
Either that or we'll go to maybe an instrumental.
Yeah.
That's where the poquitas come in.
Yeah. Yes, right. give you a break, or mm-hmm. who knows, maybe in the future I imagine myself maybe singing a song or two, you know.
Hey, just to Adriana, start judging their pay on participation.
So that depends on.
I sang two songs tonight. Okay, that's another $20 right
yeah.
there.
Yeah. That's a good idea.
Evaluations.
That'll determine your pay rate, right?
Yeah. Stevie D said, "We'd like to talk to Adriana's contact for our fest. DM me."
Oh, there you go.
Wait,
Hold on
a second.
Hey,
where do you
make it happen?
Stevie B?
Stevie
D? That's a Stevie B? I'm sorry, man.
Wrong one.
That freestyle.
We got Stevie B.
Stevie B, you can contact them directly. Contact them directly for a festival. These guys are fantastic, and we know it, and I'm sure you know it too. So this is how you reach Adriana and the Boyz for this festival that you've got. And Stevie D's got like all kinds of connections. So Stevie, yeah. My boy, you know, one hand washes the other. We'll get you on the show here. Get them on the show there.
Thank you.
Yeah. And Stevie D is also a part of Freddie Records out there in Corpus Christi too. So.
Ese vato soy como yo López.
Yeah, Stevie, isn't Stevie in charge of record contracts? Yeah, Stevie, let's sign him up, buddy.
Sign him up, man. Sign him up. Get him an audition for the big man.
Yeah.
There you go. Let's see.
Bring him down.
They're messing with you, Juan. This is Daniel Martinez from here in Colorado.
He wants to know when you and Juan are
getting married. Wedding date. The public wants to know. When are you going to make an honest woman out of Lila? So, yeah. So
uh-oh.
You guys have been, you've been together how many years now? How long that you guys have been engaged?
And together or
engaged?
That's
what I thought. Crickets.
That's two different questions. That's two different questions. Together, anyway, together about it.
Go ahead. We want to know the wedding date. When's the wedding date, Juan? Put Lila on. That's what I want. Lila!
Yeah,
Lila.
She's the shot caller.
Whenever she wants.
FaceTime Lila. Oh.
We've been together about 8 years already. Uh-huh. Been engaged one.
What's the hold up, man?
Something.
Man, get that sheepish look off your face. What's the hold up?
No pressure.
Man, no pressure.
Adriana, you love being married, don't you?
I did.
Did?
Wow. Yeah.
Wait. You said
you're married. You said I did.
Oh, what? No, I do.
She does. Freudian slip. Oh, my gosh. And we heard it first here on the Three Amigos show. There's trouble in
the exclusive, B.
Oh, yeah, let's get close-up. Can we zoom in on Adriana's face here? Oh, so, Adriana, what's going on?
HR says she's riding you up.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, Lila's in charge of HR around here. I can't make racist, sexist, or any other kind of comments so without being written up.
Any kind of assist.
So, as you all heard earlier, Adriana said she did love being married, but things have changed during the course of this interview. Of course, my natural loveliness had a lot to do with that.
Things were much simpler back then.
Oh, God.
Hey, we've got this recorded, too, so, you
know. I'm a child.
Where's the Hano Nation when you need them?
Uh-oh.
Yeah, gonna exploit this. Nation.
You'll make commercials for everything. Hey, D gets his foot stuck in the door. That's a commercial. Oh, man. We just went off the rails.
So.
Big congratulations going out to D Burleson and for a brand new album, Culturas.
You forgot my partner's name. Delia's gonna kill you, dude.
She probably will.
Yeah, for D. Burleson and
and Delia Gonzalez.
Delia.
Delia. Congratulations on your new album.
Yeah. You guys played together really good.
I need a new partner. Adriana.
Maybe we can do a duet.
Maybe you guys can open for Contreras.
There you go. There you go. That's a good idea. I'll pitch in.
There you go. Yeah. But speaking of Contreras,
on a special episode of the Three Amigos Show, it's Friday Night Live, featuring some of Tejano's best and brightest. This week we have Contreras. D and Delia, the Double D's, will be on hand to talk about the new album, their upcoming tour, and why they're back. That's Contreras, this Friday on a special episode of The Three Amigos Show, Friday Night Live, only on Tejano TV.
That's right. Juan, you did not. How many times did you say Double D's in that one commercial you did? Man. Yeah, it's D and Delia, and we came up with the term Double D's, and Juan just wore it out. So thanks, man.
See what happens when you implant that stuff in my head, though?
So we're going to be known as the Double D's from now on. That's cool.
Yes.
Cool.
The double. Hey, I can tell them your real name.
Ooh. And we're moving on. So, Adriana, guys, thank you for being on the show. We've had a wonderful time today. It's been a blast. Rick, thank you for volunteering to come out of the cave you're in. Oh, by the way, Rick, I just needed to ask you one important question. Do you have any restraining orders from, you know, all the artists that you stalk?
Well, they started to lock the doors on me when I walked out. So, you know.
I meant to ask Adriana if she had a restraining order against you, but she seems to like me.
Well, they're like 5 states away, so I don't think it's really that big of a situation. Yeah.
It don't apply way up there.
All right. Well, before we go, we want to get into the latest single that they do have out, and this one is called Oy Me Voy. Awesome jam. Make sure you guys, like I said, stream it on all streaming platforms. Make sure you guys request it on all your stations and continue to vote for it on MasChingonRadio.com. So let's go ahead and get into the new single. And this one's called Hoy Me Voy, right here on the Three Amigos Show, Tejano TV. All right, awesome single right there. Oi me voy, brand new. The congratulations on that. That is an awesome song.
Thank you. Thank you.
He's looking at me like I'm saying something, so go ahead.
You left us speechless.
Pretty much. Dean,
let me ask you a question, D.
Sure.
You're in Colorado, correct?
Yes.
You have how's the Tejano community culture happening in Colorado? Because I remember taking a few trips to Colorado and it was pretty much alive. Is it still that way?
There's only one place that has Tejano music. That's Greeley, Colorado. That's the only place that books. Denver doesn't have it. Colorado Springs doesn't have it. Fort Collins. Why do you think I live here? Nobody knows what I do. So that's pretty cool. I used to get mobbed in San Antonio. So yeah. It's kind of, I can go grocery shopping now.
Wow.
Regular people.
Oye, Juan, where are you based out of?
South of San Antonio, a little town called Cotula.
Oh, sí conozco Cotula.
Cotula.
My mom lives in Cotula.
Your mom lives in Cotula?
My mom lives in Cotula. Diana. Diana. Diana Derry.
I have a song about her. ¿Quién es la chula?
I think my wife knows her. My wife's from here.
Yeah, she's got this like really curly long hair, you know. So she's been living there for a good 8-9 years now, and she loves it, you know. For as little as that town is, she loves Cotula.
Wow, this is a very small world, isn't it?
And see, the thing is that my mom was born there.
And came back.
Well, yeah. Well, my parent, my mom, and all of her siblings, because it's a total of 12. The majority of them were all born there. In what my mom says is their home, and but then migration, and you know, having to, you know, come up north. We pretty much planted ourselves here, but again, my mom made her way back to her hometown. And, you know, I get to visit. So it's
fun. Might be related to my wife too, then.
Hey, we could be. It's we're the Velas over there, so I don't know.
Wait a minute. You know, I'm already in trouble with HR. I don't need Adriana on her side too.
Yeah, she says she knows your mom.
Oh well, I hope it's in good terms. And
oh, you're Rick, where are you at, buddy?
I'm over here in Dallas, Texas.
Yeah, Dallas.
Where in Dallas? Dallas Metroplex, Grand Prairie?
No, Dallas.
Orale.
Oak Cliff. Right in Dallas.
Oak Cliff?
Pleasant Grove.
Okay.
Orale. He knows about Oak Cliff.
Wow. No, not in the hood. Not in the hood.
I don't go to Oak Cliff.
Nobody. I don't know how it is now, but back in the day, back in the...
I don't go to Oak Cliff, and I don't date girls from Oak Cliff.
Oh, wow, so you guys are spread out. Huh? You three guys are south,
west,
northeast, and Colorado. You guys are pretty spread out.
Yeah, we're pretty everywhere.
Marcus Daniels in Waco.
I have never met, so not yet.
Oh, really?
We've been together 3 years now.
Yeah, about 3 or 4 years. We never met.
Not personally, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. You guys click pretty good.
Well, he's the boss. So I just do what he says.
I'm the one that signs over the paychecks to him. So, I mean.
Yeah, I'm still doing the same page when I got hired.
I was going to say, my wife used to live in Chicago for about 20 years.
Really? Wow.
That's how small this world is.
Wow.
And then witness protection put her in Cthulhu, huh?
Witness protection, yeah. Well, you're not going to come back to the scene of the crime. Yeah, that's how small this world is. So,
yeah.
Well, if you're ever in the area, you stop. Let us know. We'll all have lunch or something together.
Yeah. Now I know. No.
Likewise, if you're ever in the area up here, not up here in the Midwest, I got a lot of carnales that will back you up.
You know where?
And myself, aquí tienes tu casa.
You know where? You
have home here.
I just want to know who's
paying. You know where Hoffman Estate is?
Yes.
Yes.
I was over there.
Is that a good thing?
Yeah, I mean that's not a bad town. They're gonna be further north from where we're at.
Mm-hmm.
I want to live in Cicero, man. That's where I want to live.
Cicero, you know,
a lot of history.
Don't need some backup in Cicero.
No, yeah, that's okay.
That's a lot of history. You're there in the city. You're there, the beginning of the suburbs, right? There was a lot of mafia back in the 60s and 50s. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah.
A lot of the what do they call it? The wise guys.
The outfit.
Wise guys.
Yeah. The white guys, yeah.
Capone.
I'm sure they're still around, you know, but back then it was.
We better stop this conversation before we get in trouble with something. Thank you guys for coming on to the Three Amigos Show. We so
thank you.
Much continued success to all of you. Man, you guys are great.
Yes.
Thank you. Likewise. Likewise.
You've earned it. You've earned it. And I want to see people make good on it.
Man.
Thank you.
Rick.
Thank you, guys.
Yes, thank you. Let's give a couple more shout-outs real quick before we end the show. Nano says, I remember when Adriana jumped on the stage with us. I was performing in Elgin, and she sang Juntos with us.
Who is that?
Nano?
Raul Nano Fuentes.
Who did he play with?
No, see, okay, first tip, just say, yeah, I remember.
Yeah, I remember.
Oh, yeah.
I remember.
Because you don't know when you might need this guy later.
Yeah.
Right now he's going, she doesn't even remember? Oh, man, that chick.
I've had a lot of great opportunities by going up on stage with other bands. So
too late, you can't save this one. Yeah. Sorry, you can't save it. Sorry.
It's all right.
Already recorded.
It's all right. I'm sure they'll forgive me.
Maricela Oblea says, hi, Adriana and the boys. Love the song. Maricela Oblea and Amanda from
Amanda. Thank you guys so much for your continued love and support.
These guys are our number one fans. We appreciate all the support that you give us, her and her daughter.
Yes.
See, you pretended like you knew these guys. You got to do that with all of us.
they're bigger number one fans than Rick.
I know, really.
That's good advice.
Nano says, I think the Three Amigos Show needs to do the NITCS Fest.
Yes, I recall.
Well, it's now called the Illinois Tejano Organization. But same people.
Yeah, hey, tell them, hook it up, man.
Get us
business class. We want the penthouse suites, all that stuff, man. We want buffet vouchers, buffet vouchers and everything. Hit us up. We're down. Hoffman Estates is nice. And I was a keyboard player for Explosivo.
Oh, okay. Yeah, no, that was a good time too.
See, if you pretended
time
early,
there
you
this
go, would not
yeah.
be an issue.
Hey, sorry. Yeah, no. I'm sorry. Forgive me.
She didn't have too many of that yet.
Yeah, she didn't have too many yet. No more Marasul tequila for Adriana, guys. Just cut her off.
All right. We want to thank you guys so much for joining us here. Adriana, the boys, thank you so much for joining us and being a part of our show today.
Should be rid of the sponsors.
Yeah.
But I want to thank my baby Lila Cervantes, with Lila's Promotions, Archie's Homestyle Burger, Danny Farias, Janie's Record Shop, Hacienda International, and of course Marazul
Tequila,
the new face of tequila. And I am El Mas Chingon, Juan Mendoza,
and I am DD Boom Boom,
and I'm the Slickster Slick Rick.
And our guest tonight was
and I'm Adriana from Adriana and the Boys.
And one of the boys.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where everybody at?
Ya se fueron. It's late for them.
Everybody done went to sleep already. They got late on that one. But thank you so much for joining us here. And like I said, right before we leave, we want to thank everybody for showing so much love. Now we're on Google Play for your Android devices. Make sure you guys download Tejano TV. Right now it's fairly new, so it might not be available as soon as you search it. But you can always scan the QR code right there, and it will pop up. And right now we're also going to be working on the iPhone services as well. So thank you guys. And make sure you guys check out our merchandise shop. We got shirts, koozies, tumblers. You can get a mix and match 3 for $50. Get you a shirt, koozie, and a tumbler, $50. Show us some support. That way we can buy a new bus and head out there to Illinois. Too soon. Just kidding. I don't want to get sued.
Call for Lucky Joe.
I don't want to get sued. Thank you guys so much for joining us here. We really appreciate it. And next week we're gonna have Geneva, and tune in this Friday for Culturas.
Awesome. So, well, thank you guys so much. Thank you guys so much for having us on live here and interviewing us. And I just want to go ahead and give a big old shout out to my mama. I love you, Mama Diana Derry, and to all my family and friends and all my fans and followers who have continued to support Adriana and the Boyz.
Everybody in Cotulla, Texas.
And Cotulla, Texas.
Thank you.
All right, we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Next time on The Three Amigos Show. With a uniquely powerful voice, Geneva comes to The Three Amigos Show. Nominated as Best New Female Artist, she's made her mark on the Tejano industry. Geneva. Join us on April 10th when Geneva sits down with the Boyz to discuss her perspective on women in the industry and how she wants to make a change. Be here when we talk to Geneva, right here on The Three Amigos Show. Brought to you by Maschingon Radio, LalaLisaPromotions.com, Hacienda International Productions, musician Danny Farias, Marazul Tequila, taste the new face of tequila, Archie's Homestyle Burgers in Cotulla, Texas, Janie's Record Shop in San Antonio, Texas, and Tejano TV. You can view The Three Amigos Show on all your favorite streaming platforms and on all your Roku devices. The Three Amigos Show.